Hello everyone! Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat at maligayang pagbabalik sa bahay ni Teacher Rocky! Yes, this is your part of our RPMS Serie 2023 at dahil natapos na natin ang discussion ng lahat ng classroom observable indicators for this school year, tama po ang nakikita nyo sa description ng ating video. Today, we're going to discuss about how to craft or how to design your fourth quarter lesson plan. The lesson plan that we will use for the fourth quarter classroom observation. Remember, we are only required two classroom observations ano po, for this school year. One for the third quarter, nakagawa na tayo ng video para doon. I'll leave here the link for that kung hindi nyo pa napapanood paano gumawa ng lesson plan for the third quarter classroom observation. And for today's video, ang ating video will be about paano gumawa ng lesson plan para sa ating fourth quarter classroom observation following the six classroom observable indicators, and those are classroom observable indicators 1 to 3 and then 7, 8, 9. Tama po, yun lang po ang i-rate sa ating mga proficient teachers para sa fourth quarter classroom observation. Okay? So bago po tayo mag-umpisa, katulad ng nakagawian natin, umpisahan natin ang ating video sa ating mga pa-shoutout. Konti lang to. I would like to start with Ma'am Girl 15. Sabi niya, God bless Teacher Rocky. Thank you so much po. And then we also have from Ma'am Elisa Mijares. Hello Teacher Rocky, God bless you more. Thank you so much po. And from Ma'am Bernadette Irma Cabalia. Hello po Teacher Rocky, God bless you more. Salamat po. From Ma'am Zen Villanueva. Hello po sa maulang panahon. Ito yung panahon siguro na nag-uulan dyan sa Pilipinas. Well, I heard ngayon, nag-iinit naman. Sobrang summer na daw. Opposite dito sa amin. Ang lamig. And from Sir Jose Brazil Vencito. Wow, objective 10 na po tayo. Thanks po again, Teacher Rocky. More blessings po. Thank you po. From Ma'am Grace Irene Rebuyas. Objective 10 na. Malapit na matapos. Tama po. And from Ma'am Jupina Saure, good morning Teacher Rocky, thank you po, you're welcome po. We also have from Ma'am Linza Navarro, good morning Teacher Rocky, thank you so much for all your sacrifices to guide us teachers, you're very much welcome po. And from Ma'am Euphemia Dolores, thank you Teacher Rocky, you are a blessing to us. Thank you so much po. I am really grateful and I feel flattered to be a blessing po sa inyong lahat. I know na hindi po lahat ay na kaya kong i-please, pero salamat po sa mga nakaka-appreciate ng ating effort. Thank you so much and God bless you all as well. With that, wait lang po. Meron pa akong gustong i-flex. Gusto ko rin po i-shout out si Ma'am Jubilin Bokoran. Ayan. Si Ma'am Jubilin Bokoran po is from Auckland, New Zealand. Maraming salamat po sa kanyang pa-winter jacket. Ayan. Meron akong sponsor sa winter jacket ko for today's video. Ang ganda. Maraming salamat po. At sobrang sakto. Pinadala niya to all the way from Auckland to here. Thank you so much. By the way, si Ma'am Jubilin Bokoran is also a vlogger. Ilagay ko dito yung kanyang link sa kanyang YouTube channel. Siya po ay isang guro. Matagal lang guro dito sa New Zealand. Ang mga content niya po ay tungkol sa kung paan maging teacher dito sa New Zealand at iba't ibang mga kaalaman sa pagiging guro dito sa New Zealand. If you want to check on those videos, napakaganda po. Ang dami niyang natutulungan. You can check her channel. Thank you so much, Ma'am Jubilin. And with that, let us start our crafting lesson plan for the fourth quarter classroom demonstration video at this point. For today's video, we are going to help you in designing lesson plan for the fourth quarter classroom observation using the six classroom observable indicators for the fourth quarter according to the DepEd Memorandum 008 Series of 2023 or the Multi-Year Guidelines on the RPMS IPCRF.
Let us go back to the schedule and distribution of classroom observable indicators across quarters for proficient teachers for school year 2022 to 2023, according to the DepEd memorandum. So for this school year, we are only asked to perform two classroom observation, and that will be for the third and fourth quarter. So for the fourth quarter, we will be rated according to the classroom observable indicators 1, 2, and 3, and classroom observable indicators 7, 8, and 9. So ito lang po ang i-rate sa atin during the fourth quarter classroom observation. Let us go back to the third quarter rating sheet. So for the third quarter, kung nakapag-perform na tayo ng classroom observation for the third quarter, we should have been rated only for the classroom observable indicators 1 up to 6. So ito lang pong first 6 classroom observable indicators dapat tayo ni-rate. That's according to the schedule of distribution of classroom observable indicators na galing sa DepEd memorandum. For the fourth quarter rating sheet, we will be rated on the first 3 indicators in the classroom observable indicators 1, 2, and 3, and classroom observable indicators 7, 8, and 9. Ibig sabihin, yung 4, 5, and 6, hindi po i-rate ng ating observers. Okay? So we'll only be rated with the 6 classroom observable indicators. And these indicators, 1, 2, and 3, kasama din po ito dun sa ating ni-rate. Kung saan tayo ni rate ng third quarter classroom observable in classroom observation, that's indicators 1, 2, and 3. For the fourth quarter, 7, 8, 9 naman instead of 4, 5, 6. Ano po? So ito po ang indicators na to ang kailangan nating siguraduhin na maipe-perform at maipapakita during our fourth quarter classroom observation to make sure that we'll get the highest possible score. So let us start with objective 1 of the RPMS for school year 2022 to 2023. Objective 1 is also our classroom observable indicator number 1. So this is applied knowledge of content within and across curriculum teaching areas. Para lang po linawin, ang tinutukoy po dito ng within and across curriculum teaching areas is not the knowledge of the students. Hindi po yung kaalaman ng estudyante ang hinahanap dito, kundi ang atin pong kaalaman at kakayahan bilang guro. Ang ating kaalaman tungkol sa content ng ating lesson at kung paano natin to i-integrate sa ibang curriculum teaching areas. At para matulungan tayo na ma-perform ito ng maayos, we will be using PPST 1.1.2 or the PPST Resource Package Module 1 to explain to us how to perform this indicator. Imperative to our profession is our ability to demonstrate accurate, in-depth, and broad knowledge of the concepts we deliver in every teaching opportunity. So that is very important, imperative, and it is expected of us that we have that ability to demonstrate how much, how in-depth we know about the topic that we're discussing. Likewise, our proficiency to make every learning occasion a meaningful way to connect one lesson to another and to the real world is a necessity. Kailangan din po. Hindi lang alam na alam natin yung lesson, kundi at kung paano din natin ito maikoconnect sa ibang learning areas, teaching or learning areas, and to the real world. Okay? For this classroom indicator, teachers should be able to show that they have an in-depth knowledge of the lesson and that they were able to incorporate the lesson to other learning areas from within or other learning levels. So yun yung importante sa objective 1 or the classroom observable indicator 1. Paano natin may papakita sa observer na alam natin yung lesson at kaya natin itong i-connect sa ibang learning areas? Next one is the objective 2, which is also our classroom observable indicator number 2. Used a range of teaching strategies that enhance learner achievement in literacy and numeracy skills. So, ibig sabihin po, kailangang maipakita natin during our classroom observation that we also apply different teaching strategies that will help our learners with literacy and numeracy regardless of our subject matter. Kahit ang subject matter natin ay PE, music, dapat ma-incorporate pa rin natin yung teaching strategy to help our students in literacy and numeracy skills. Mas maiintindihan natin ang indicator na to if we consult the PPST 1.4.2 or the Module 2 of the PPST resource package. As teachers, central to our role is to build a strong foundation in literacy and numeracy among learners and strengthen their ability to engage in education, reach their potential, and participate fully in the community. So it is our duty, it is our role as a teacher, hindi lang para sa mga English teachers, hindi lang para sa mga mathematics teachers, but for all teachers in general, it is our role, it is our responsibility that we will be able to build a strong foundation for our students in literacy and numeracy skills. Kaya dapat kasama lagi ito sa ating lesson, and that is objective 2. Next one is objective 3, which is our classroom observable indicator number 3. Applied a range of teaching strategies to develop critical and creative thinking as well as other higher order thinking skills. We should be able to show during our classroom observation that we provide teaching strategies or activities in our lesson that will help our students develop their critical and creative thinking. We let our students think more. Hindi lang basta think, but to think more. So we can be we can do this indicator by consulting the PPST 1.5.2 or the PPST Resource Package Module 3. So more than making our learners remember what we teach, we also want them to use the knowledge they learn to analyze problems, evaluate options, and create solutions. Hindi lang basta matandaan nila kung ano yung lesson or maintindihan nila kung anong lesson. It is also important that we let them think beyond the lesson that was taught. Mas makapag-isip pa sila in a higher order thinking skills of from anything that we discussed in the lesson. This can only be possible when learners are provided with classroom environments that develop and nurture their thinking skills. So it is important that we provide them with an environment that will nurture their thinking skills. Next one, we go to objective 7, which is also our classroom observable indicator 7. Ito yung pang-apat na indicator sa ating fourth quarter classroom observation. This is planned, managed, and implemented developmentally sequenced teaching and learning processes to meet curriculum requirements in varied teaching contexts. For this indicator, it will be helpful to consult PPST 4.1.2 or the Module 7 of the PPST resource package. For this indicator, ang tinitingnan po dito mostly is our lesson plan. Paano natin na ipakita that we follow the sequence of the lesson plan template or the lesson plan structure. Dapat nasundan natin ng mabuti yung bawat part ng lesson plan and each function of its part. So dapat maipakita natin during our classroom observation that we were able to plan, manage, and implemented developmentally sequenced teaching and learning process through our lesson plan. Basically, ang tinitingnan lang dito is our lesson plan at kung paano natin sinunod sequentially yung every parts ng lesson plan. As proficient teachers, we are driven to design lessons that satisfy the need to making teaching and learning processes seamless and progressive for our learners. We start by familiarizing ourselves with the content of the curriculum as the Bible from which we refer to in planning our lessons. The competencies found in the curriculum guide or the CG are what should be mastered by the learners at the end of every lesson. So nakafocus tayo lagi dun sa competencies that have to be achieved for that specific lessons. In terms of designing a developmentally sequenced learning plan, teachers just need to religiously follow the parts of the daily lesson log. Kailangan lang daw sundin religiously the parts of the daily lesson log template. As for DepEd Ed Order 42, Series 2016, also known as the Policy Guidelines on the Daily Lesson Preparation for the K-12 Basic Education Program, the use of the Daily Lesson Log or DLL or the Detailed Lesson Plan or the DLP enables the teacher to guide, mentor, and support learners in developing and assessing their learning across the curriculum. Even in this department order, learner scaffolding is given much attention. Hence, teachers need to be guided by what the DLL or the DLP suggests to capture the conduct of more developmental teaching and learning procedures. So malinaw po that it is being prescribed that we use the DLL or DLP template from the DepEd Order Number 42 Series of 2016. I understand that some of us are using a different lesson plan template. Alam ko po, naunawaan ko, that this is a localized arrangement in different schools. Some schools would require yung mga 4A's, 7A's, at kung ano-ano pang iba't ibang klaseng lesson plan. But if we are going to look at a PPST Resource Package 4.1.2, it is highly recommended that we use DepEd Number 42 Series of 2016 DLL or DLP template. Ano po? Kasi daw, ito daw, it enable the teacher to guide, mentor, and support learners in developing and assessing their learning across the curriculum. So, it is said that this template from the DepEd Order Number 42 Series of 2016 is designed specifically for learner scaffolding, scaffolding the learning process. Yung bawat part daw ng DLL at DLP template from this DepEd Order would help scaffold the learning. Kaya sinasuggest that we use this DLL or DLP template. Next one is objective number 9. Okay, objective number 9 po ito from our RPMS tool. We skip objective 8 kung napansin nyo kasi ang objective 8 po from our RPMS tool is a non-classroom observable indicator. So we proceed to objective 9 which is the classroom observable indicator number 8 sa ating mga rating sheet. Ano po? Ito po ang ating classroom observable indicator number 8 which said, selected, developed, organized, and used appropriate teaching and learning resources including ICT to address learning to be able to achieve this objective, we can make use of the PPST 4.5.2 or the PPST Resource Package Module 8. Okay? As teachers, we are expected to provide appropriately developed teaching and learning resources to effectively deliver our lesson. These teaching and learning resources, or what we call TLRs, support the learning experience of learners in order to enhance their academic achievement. So for this objective, what we are expected of is that we provided our students with different teaching and learning resources, and that includes the use of ICT. So therefore, dapat sa ating lesson proper during our classroom observation, maipakita natin na gumamit tayo ng iba't ibang teaching and learning resources. Ang teaching and learning resources, well, teaching resources can be found from our curriculum guide, yung ating mga teacher's guide, that is our teaching resources. For the learning resources, we can provide them with different materials, worksheet that can help them acquire the knowledge that we are supposed to give them or the competency for that specific lesson. So, paano tayo nakapagbigay, nakapag-provide ng iba't ibang materials na to, including ICT? Yun yung titingnan at i-rate for this classroom observable indicator. The proper selection, development, organization, and utilization of teaching and learning resources, including ICT, helps enhance and maximize learners' participation through providing them with teaching and learning resources that can be seen or heard, which provide concrete experiences about the lessons. So it is very important that we provide them with different learning materials because that would help them be interested more in the lesson. Pag may nakikita silang mga learning materials, pag may mga napapanood sila through video presentation, nakukuha natin yung attention nila and that will make them learn more. Pag hindi natin nakuha ang attention ng ating mga students, they will get bored at hindi na nila iintindihin the entire lesson. So it is important that we provide them with different materials that will catch their attention and eventually their interest in the lesson. These teaching and learning resources should not only give vibrancy to the classroom setting by adding color and appeal to the learners, but also help the teachers address the learning goals. So it is not just to catch the attention, although it will help, pero hindi lahat yon, hindi yun lang. It is more important that we use these teaching and learning resources to help us address the learning goals or achieve the learning goals for the specific lesson. Next one is Objective 10, which is our classroom observable indicator number 9. Designed, selected, organized, and used diagnostic, formative, and summative assessment strategies consistent with curriculum requirements. So for this classroom observable indicator, ang hinahanap sa atin dito is kung tayo ay nakapag-provide ng iba't ibang klaseng assessment strategies. So we have three kinds of assessment strategies. We have the diagnostic, formative, and summative. Dapat makita to during our classroom observation. And the PPST 5.1.2 or the PPST Resource Package Module 9 will help us achieve this objective. As proficient teacher, we are expected to design, select, organize, and use diagnostic, formative, and summative assessment strategies consistent with curriculum requirements. In this explanation, we will be guided by how to put or to design, select, organize, and use these different assessment strategies. Assessment and instruction are parallel in a classroom that focuses on the learner. Teachers need to use a variety of strategies to assess learner readiness for a particular unit of study and to plan their instruction around the needs the learners demonstrate. Ongoing assessment of student learning is an important part of the learning process. There are three main types of assessment. They are pre-assessment, formative assessment, and summative assessment. This is what should reflect during our classroom observation. So ano ba itong mga different kinds of assessment na to? Pag sinabing pre-assessment or the diagnostic assessment, this is the assessment that is used to collect information about learner's strengths, weaknesses, knowledge, and skills prior to instruction. So bago natin ibigay yung ating lesson proper, we wanted to know, wanted to assess how much the learner knows their weaknesses and their strengths. So usually this is given before a lesson or a unit of study. We would usually give diagnostic assessment to determine the readiness level of learners and to introduce new instruction. While the formative assessment is that kind of assessment that gathers information about student learning. So this is done during a lesson or unit of study. While you were giving the new lesson, you conduct formative assessment to track learners' progress and to make changes to instruction. Para malaman natin, how is it going? Naiintindihan ba ng ating mga estudyante so far ang ating dinidiscuss? Kailangan ba nating ulitin? Kailangan ba nating, pwede na ba tayong mag-proceed to the next topic? So that's a formative assessment. On the other hand, the summative assessment is the assessment that shows what learners have learned. So this is conducted usually at the end of a lesson or unit of study so that we can provide evidence of what learners learned. Okay, so the pre-assessment or the diagnostic is before the lesson, the formative is while the lesson is ongoing, and then the summative is at the end of a lesson. With that, we are now ready to craft our lesson plan for the fourth quarter classroom observation. I have here an example of my lesson plan for the fourth quarter classroom observation. You would notice that I use the DepEd Order 42 Series of 2016 Detailed Lesson Plan Format. Kasi yun yung ina-advise ng PPST Resource Package that we make use this specific format. We can make use the DLL or the DLP. For a more precise example, I decided to make use of the DLP. Remember, according to the DepEd Order number 42 Series of 2016, ang gagamit ng DLP are those teachers that are new to service or have not had a year of experience. Those teachers that had more than a year of experience in teaching and doing lesson plan can use DLL or the daily lesson log. Okay, para malinaw lang. But for this explanation, I would like to make use of the DLP format para mas focus. So this is the example lesson plan. So So let us try to look at each part of the detailed lesson plan to make sure or to prove that it is a developmentally sequenced lesson plan. So the first one of the DLP from DepEd Order 42 Series of 2016 is the objective. So yung objective naman natin, kinukuha lang natin yan from our curriculum guide that includes the content standard and performance standard of the specific lesson. For letter C, learning competencies or objective. So pwede tayong maglagay dito ng ating objective, or we can make use of the learning competencies from the curriculum guide. So yun yung ginawa ko. Kinuha ko yung learning competency that we need to achieve for this specific lesson, and also the competency code. Ayan, nandiyan nakalagay. Then we have the content or the main topic, the different napkin folding styles, and we also have the different learning resources. Ayan. And for the procedure, we start with reviewing previous lesson, and then after reviewing, this is reviewing previous lesson, o kaya pwede rin presenting the new lesson. So, whichever is applicable for your lesson. And then letter B, establishing a purpose for the lesson. So, this is somewhat introducing your lesson or giving our students a hint of what we're going to have for the day. And then for letter C, presenting examples or instances of the new lesson. So, this is discussing about the new lesson na. And then discussing new concepts and practicing new skills. Discussing new concepts and practicing skills, number two. And the letter F, developing mastery, which leads to formative assessment. We also have letter G, finding practical applications of concepts. Relate ng ating mga estudyante ang ating lesson to their daily living. And then making generalizations and abstractions about the lesson and evaluating learning. And then lastly, additional activities for application or remediation. The next part after this is the remarks and reflection, which the teachers would have to accomplish after giving the lesson. So, i-fill out natin yan pagkatapos nating magawa yung lesson na yon after the day's lesson. Okay, so ibig sabihin, if you followed religiously, sabi sa PPST resource package, if you follow religiously the different steps in the detailed lesson plan from DepEd Order number 42 Series of 2016, that is indicator number 7. Okay, planned, managed, and implemented developmentally sequenced teaching and learning processes to meet curriculum requirements and varied teaching contexts. Okay, but just the same, ipapacheck po natin to, kaya meron tayong pre-con with our observer bago yung mismong classroom observation para ma-check ni observer if the lesson plan that you have prepared is developmentally sequenced. Okay? So, i-check nila yan. Kung meron silang gustong improve or baguhin, they will do suggestions. But that would go to indicator number 7. Okay? Next one, let's go to the procedure part, letter B, establishing a purpose for the lesson. So, dito sa aking establishing a purpose for the lesson, appreciating arts. So, dito, I show them, the teacher show pictures of different artworks by two. So, dalawa ng dalawa, tapos papipiliin ko sila, which one do you think is better? Why? Explain why. So, that is appreciating arts, and that is indicator number 1, applied knowledge of content within and across curriculum teaching areas, because I was able to integrate my lesson to arts. Okay? So, that is across curriculum teaching area. So, mayroon na tayong dalawang indicator. Next one, we'll go to the letter D and letter E part, discussing new concepts and practicing new skills. Number 1, for this one, ipinakita ko sa kanila how I read the steps in creating or making napkin folding styles, how I read them, and how I follow each instruction to be able to come up with napkin folding styles. Then for letter E, discussing new concepts and practicing new skills, number 2, I let the students do the same thing that I did. So I would call 2 students to perform in front of the class. The first one will read the steps or the instructions, babasahin at uunawain, and then the second one will have to follow each given instructions. With this, I was able to show indicator number 2, use a range of teaching strategies that enhance learner achievement in literacy and numeracy skills. So literacy skills, ako nag-focus for this lesson. So it is understanding steps and instructions, okay? Pagbabasa, tamang pagbabasa at tamang pag-unawa ng mga given steps and instructions. Next one is letter F, developing mastery, which leads to formative assessment. Okay, so for this one, I inform the students that in test assessment, which they hopefully would go through after the food and beverage services training, they have to perform 10 napkin folding styles in 10 minutes. So, papraktisin namin to. So, I group them into four, and then each group will have to perform 10 different styles and 10 table and 10 different napkin folding styles in 10 minutes. So here they were provided with the with 10 table napkin each of the group, and then ang gagawin nila, they will have to decide paano nila maipa-perform yung 10 napkin folding styles in 10 minutes. So mag-a-assign sila ng bawat member of the group kung ano ang gagawing napkin folding style. So they have to do it one by one. So the fastest that can finish the task will be the winner of the game. So provided, of course, is the rubrics in rating their performance. And for letter G, finding practical applications of concepts and skills in daily living, we ask the students, we have the learners come up with a real life situation where they can use their skills in napkin folding. So they will have to think, after learning this napkin folding styles, paano ba nila ito magagamit? Saan ba nila ito pwedeng gamitin? With that, I was able to show indicator number 3, which is apply the range of teaching strategies to develop critical and creative thinking, as well as higher order thinking skills. Next one, and this part is the learning resources. So for, unfortunately, for TLE subjects, especially in senior high school, wala po kami masyadong references. So for teacher's guide, I make use of the curriculum guide. And for learner's materials, meron tayong mga module na ginamit natin during the pandemic period, nagbigay tayo ng mga module dyan. So, meron na tayong nagagamit. And then, I'm afraid walang masyadong makukuha sa learning resource portal ng mga lesson for this, for TLE subjects. Meron ding iba, pero for the purpose of this, I did some other learning resources. So, kumuha ako ng video sa YouTube na pwede nilang panoorin. I also had a PowerPoint presentation. And I crafted my own learning materials for the lesson. So, with that, I was able to show indicator number 8, selected, develop, organize, and use appropriate teaching and learning resources, including ICT to address learning goals. Next one, kung titingnan natin ang ating lesson plan, in this part of the procedure, letter A, we're in the reviewing previous lesson or presenting the new lesson. This is my pre-assessment, kung saan I was able to assess how much my students knows about the lesson. So I gave them the topic, tapos they will have to fill in the worksheet with what the facts that they already know, what they wanted to know, and other questions that they might want to explore. So this is assessing their prior knowledge. So that's pre-assessment. Next one, in this part, while we are discussing the topic, I try to assess how much they know or how much they can do napkin folding through these different activities. So this is a continuation of those activities, and that is formative assessment, okay? Assessing the learner's needs, assessing what they currently know, so that we would know if we have to reteach, if we have to teach the topic again, or we can proceed to the next topic. So that is formative assessment. And in this part, evaluating learning is our summative assessment. Remember, ang summative assessment natin can be in the form of a written work, a performance task, or quarterly assessment. So for this lesson, I conducted performance tasks for the students to assess how much each of them have learned. And that is indicator number 9, designed, selected, organized, and used diagnostic, formative, and summative assessment strategies consistent with curriculum requirements, because we should always focus to the objective of our lesson, which is to learn the different kinds of napkin folding styles.
Ayan. So, ayan. I hope by this time, kaya na nating buuhin ang ating lesson plan for the fourth quarter classroom observation. Pagkatapos nito, susundan na natin to ng lahat ng anim na non-classroom observable indicators po para matapos na natin ang ating RPMS tool for proficient teachers for school year 2022 to 2023. Maraming salamat po. And if you have questions, comments, don't hesitate to put that in our comment box. And hit that like button kung nagustuhan niyo po ang video na to. Sa mga hindi pa po nakakapag-subscribe, please do subscribe to our channel and click that notification bell to bell all para po lagi kayong updated sa ating mga bagong updates and bagong i-upload na videos tungkol sa RPMS at marami pang iba. Maraming salamat po and God bless you all and let us all be a blessing to everyone every day. Bye-bye!